All right, so in this lecture, we're going to talk about loops, mainly for loops and while loops, and other types of flow control with if statements and other things in Python. So again, I've listed a couple of additional references for you. I'm still recommending that you take the Code Academy course, Crash Course in Python. And if you want some more information on flow control, here's the link to the Python documentations. So we'll just start off. The most useful type of loop is a for loop, and the syntax for that in Python is quite easy. So if we want to create a range of numbers that we want to loop over, say from 0 to 9, then what we would do is we just use the keyword for. Then we give an iterator. A lot of times you would use I or X or something like this, but you could also use a word, item, you know, something like that. So we'll say for I in range 10. Right, and then we'll print I. And so if we run that, you see that runs from 0 to 9. Again, because Python is 0 indexed, if we want to have loop over 10, you know, a sequence of 10 numbers, 0, 1, 2, and so on to 9, then we'd have to do something like that. The range command does take an additional argument. If you'd really want, you can say range from 1 to 10. Or if you really want to go from 1 to 10, you'd have to say 1 to 11, and then you'd have that. But I usually find it's better to just start with the 0 and loop over from starting with 0. So something like that. You can also have an existing list, right? So if we create a list, say, of strings, for example, in this case, we'll just create a list that has some alphabetical characters in it. So this is a list, and we can actually just loop over that directly. So we can say for a letter, again, this could be anything, for a letter in a list, and then we'll print a letter. And that should print A, B, C, like that. I always find it much better. There are things like while loops, so you could say, you know, while my bool is not true, print I, let's say I is initially equal to 0. While my bool is not true, and of course, then we have to, at some point, set the boolean value to true. So initially, we'd have my bool equals false, and so while it's not true, we're going to print I, and then we'll go ahead and use an if statement here. So if I is greater than 10. Greater than 10, then we're going to change my bool equal to true, right? So then if we run this, you should see it count. Oh, I forgot to increment. So this is exactly why, this is a great example. It's exactly why I don't really like to use while statements, because you're just asking for to get yourself into an infinite loop. And so while I did this on accident, it actually is pretty illustrative of why I don't like to use while loops. So I've went ahead and interrupted that. Now if I go in here and I remember this time to increment I, then it does what I wanted to do. So that was a lot of syntax to sort of not do anything very interesting. And I often find it better just to always use for loops. And then in the case where you want to break out on some condition, then you just use an if statement with break, right? So we're going to say, give you another example. So next time I'll say for I in range of 100. So obviously if I don't break this, this loop will go to 100, right? But then I can put an if statement in. I can say if I is greater than 10, then just break, right? And Oop, did not mean to. So then I can just say print I. And now I will increment, and once I is greater than 10, I will break out of it. And so then I can do that. So the syntax is much, much easier. And you see, worst case there, you know, I'll never get stuck in an infinite loop. And the worst case scenario here is that I would, you know, loop to 100 and then stop, or 99 in this case, and then it would stop. So my advice is to never, there's almost, I'm not going to say that there's never a situation where you wouldn't want to use a while loop, but it's almost always preferable to use a for loop with some max iteration value, and then break out of the for loop when you meet some criteria, and that's true, okay? So in doing this, you saw that I used an if statement there. We can use it in other ways, so the syntax is fairly simple. But if we return up here, and what I'll do now is I'll actually put my print statement inside my if. And remember, in Python, white space is syntax. So if I'm inside the for loop, then I have to be tabbed over or spaced over. In this case, I'm using four spaces. The number of spaces doesn't matter, but it does have to be consistent, right? So in this case, I'm using four spaces inside the for loop, and then another four over here. And so what I'll do here is I'll add an additional statement, and the syntax is really easy, right? So if I say for I greater than 10 and I less than 20, then I'll print I. Otherwise, I'll just loop over the rest of the number. So you can see that happens, and you know, I can also do things like, you know, for I less than, for I less than 10, and or now I'll change or I less than 20. Is that going to do what I want? For I greater than 20. Yeah, that's what I want. So this, in this case, it's going to print everything except the numbers between 10 and 20, right? So there you see that. That's what I wanted to do. So that was just an example of an if statement, if and, if or. Of course, you can also have else, right, statements. So in this case, you know, we can have an else block. And in this case, you know, for the numbers in between, then we can just say print a string, you know, hello. And so if we do that, you see, we get that. So that's an example of a for loop with an if and an if else. Let's see, Python also has nice ways to test using if statements, like test if things are in a list. So if we go back to, like, say, define a list that's, again, A, B, and C, then we can say if A is in a list, then do something. In this case, say print true. Right, and of course it is, so it prints true. And then we could add an else statement, of course. We're going to print false, right? So in the case where if we wanted to test if, say, D was in the list. And, of course, we have false. So that's an example of how to use the nice sort of very simple Python syntax for testing if things are in lists. And of course, you can negate anything, right? So I can also just put a not in front of it. So if I can say if D is not in the list, print true, and that's going to have the negative operation, right? So this is just a couple examples. You know, I encourage you to look at the resources for more. And it's a very nice, easy syntax that I think you'll find really easy in Python compared to other languages.